Hello! In this video demo, I'll show you how to create a database-driven microservice in Rust, compiled to Wasm WebAssembly and run it in the WasmEdge sandbox. You are not limited to Rust though, you can do this in JavaScript too. We'll show you a complete microservice application with high-performance web server, a relational database, and even the capacity to call external web services, distributed cache, and messaging queues. For microservices, the WebAssembly sandbox is much lighter, faster, and more secure alternative to Linux containers. Furthermore, WasmEdge can be managed by existing container tools in a Kubernetes cluster. WasmEdge apps can run side-by-side with Linux container apps. So let's get started with the code. So here is a piece of Rust code that starts a HTTP server for the microservice. For every request that comes in, the handler function is invoked. It parses and processes the HTTP request and then returns the response. Now, the Rust program also creates a database connection pool to an external MySQL database. It could be MySQL, MariaDB, TiDB, or TD Engine, since the MySQL protocol is widely used. The connection pool is passed to the request handler function. The function gets a connection from the pool and then sends the SQL statements to the database. That's it for the code. Let's now build the microservice into WebAssembly bytecode. We just use the very simple cargo build command. We can now run the WebAssembly app in the WasmEdge runtime. It starts the server and listens for incoming HTTP requests. As you can see here, I'm passing the MySQL URL into the application so that it knows which MySQL database to connect to. It now listens for incoming HTTP requests. Now, from another terminal window, you can send HTTP requests to the microservice, and it would read or write into the database. The init request is to create a table in the empty database. It returns true. The create orders request sends over a JSON array of data to the microservice, and they will be saved into the database table as rows. Also returns as true. Then the query request would ask the microservice to query the database and sends back the result via a JSON response. That's it. You can clone and fork the GitHub repo and use it as a template for your own microservices. Thank you.